My, what a charming young couple. Are you a couple?
No.
No.
We're just friends.
Oh, just friends, eh? I see. So if I was to ask him, are you a couple when you weren't here, would he say maybe? Or I mean, is there anything more in it, do you think, for you guys? Or is it just going to be friends?
I would have said yes.
Oh, really? Hey, do not judge. We don't judge here. Yeah, do you think we would judge on it if we had lesbian row and... We don't judge here. Love all the people, even if they're slightly misguided. So you would say yes. But would you say yes? You're not sure yet. You don't want to hurt his feelings, or you're just not sure?
We're just really good friends.
Ah. That's a shame, because I know that he has a present for you. Given this dude never fails. Yeah, look at that. A T-shirt you can wear. Hey, whoa! You know, and we got T-shirts that are infant sizes, too. So if you guys ever, you know, get yourself a midget or something, you're good. Are you putting on now?
I am.
All right. That's... Wow, you're an impetuous one, aren't you? What are your names? Sorry.
John.
John and...
Allie.
John and Allie.
It doesn't look quite right.
No, it looks pretty good. It looks better on you than it does on him, I tell you that. So now you got your T-shirts on. It only remains for me to ask... Who's that at the door? That's especially for all the people that want me to get rid of the horse. We'll be right back, everybody. Well done, you guys.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Farmers Insurance. Find a knowledgeable local farmer's agent at farmers.com. We are insurance. We are Farmers.
Please sit down, relax. Your mock enthusiasm will cover up the weaknesses of this show. Please sit down, or we'll have you removed, madam. Sit down, thank you. You're clearly insane and got past the profilers at the front door, so... Should be an interesting one tonight. Great day for America, everybody. Is it? It is a great day for America. In just a few hours, America's first gay history museum will open in San Francisco. That's true. I'm like, in San Francisco of all places, really? I would have. I suppose. It's about time there's a gay museum in San Francisco. Basically, it's just a window and you look out and go there. Oh,
A lot of it happened over there, and it's a very big birthday this week. My favourite website is 10 years old. Happy 10th anniversary, naughtyvegetables.com. Wrestlinggrannies.com, penis.com. Well, I'm talking, of course, of Wikipedia. Wikipedia, the online encyclopedia, is 10 years this week. I think it's 10. I read that on Wikipedia, so it's probably crap. No, currently the two biggest sites on the internet, this is true, are Wikipedia, where you go to learn about things you care about, and Facebook, where you go to learn about people you stopped caring about years ago. I'm not on Facebook, so if you're angry at me for not friending you, I'm innocent. Or am I? People from all over the world edit and write articles on the Wikipedia, and they're Wikipedia. I call it that, Wikipedia. Wikipedia. Wikipedia is the male version in Spanish. There are a lot of different languages. There's 262 languages versions of Wikipedia. I didn't even know there were 262 languages. I only speak one language, Scamerican. I can barely even speak that this evening, apparently. Like everything on the in the inter-Google, though, the early days of the Wikipedia were chaotic. There was a lot of factual errors. The Wikipedia entry about me listed me as a comedian.
That's rich.
Yeah! No, then they changed it to entertainer. I'm not the only one either. A couple of years ago, the Wikipedia entry for the British pop star Robbie Williams actually said that, and this is true, it said, he ate domestic pets in pubs for money. Ridiculous. Does this look like a man who would eat a domestic pet? Ah, well, there you go. I think somebody just spotted a hamster pot pie there. Ooh, hamsters! For me, someone like me, anyway, having the Wikipedia page is great, you know, because it's about me. And I spent the 1980s mostly in a blackout, so I read the Wikipedia, I can catch up and find out what I was doing. So that's why I'm banned from Holland. I should never have touched that dike. Call me Famke Janssen. No, I mean, call me Famke Janssen. Pull my hair, kiss me, buy me dinner, rub my nipples, and call me Famke Janssen. It's probably, you're right, that's too far. Anyway, the Wikipedia's accuracy has come a long way since it started. But some people still say they're biased. And I'm like, yes, any source of second-hand information is inherently biased. How else are you going to learn about what happened during the Civil War? Larry King is retired. It's gone. Actually, Larry King is on this show next week, which is proof he's given up show business.
All right, I'll do Ferguson again. And by do Ferguson, I mean I'll pull his hair and call him Famke Janssen.
All right. Wikipedia. Yeah, the Wikipedia has entries for everything, no matter how obscure. That there's even a Wikipedia page for Wikipedia. Remember that? That's my face for doing mysterious. You can read about that on Wikipedia. There's a Wikipedia page for Wikipedia. How deep does that rabbit hole go? Stoners are watching the snow right now going, what? But they would be doing that anyway. You know, the Wikipedia is different from WikiLeaks. Wikipedia is helpful and popular. WikiLeaks is evil and scares people. They're like the cyber version of Dennis Quaid and Randy Quaid, right there. One lovely, one terrifying. Of course, the success of Wikipedia has led to imitators. There's the Star Wars site. This is true. The Star Wars one is called Wikipedia. The Disney one is called Mickeypedia, and then there's a bunch of different porn ones. There's Quickiepedia, Ickypedia, and another one that I'm not allowed to say. Well, it's commercial break time now, Jeff.
Break me off a piece of ads.
Was that kind of a play on the word ass?
I'm such a tool.
Don't be hating on yourself, man. It's all right. I just did 8 minutes of complete garbage. I'm all right.
Hold me. Hold me. Hold me.
No. No. All right, then. Maybe, no. We have to take a break. I'm going to hold Jeff.
Are you as turned on as I am?
Yeah. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. All right. Thanks very much, everybody. That was really believable. What time is it, Jeffrey Pearson?
Shake out your tweet mail bag, Craig. I'm such a tool. Balls.
Yeah. Play the thing.
Dog cat cover and don't look back. Here comes an email and Twitter attack. Giant creepy monsters crushing our city. It's a jumbo lizard wrecking committee. So grab your ray gun and your rocket back and join the email Twitter.
Attack! Hey, welcome back. All right, that was great. Welcome back from the jingle, everybody. That was such a lovely thing. I'm such a tool. All right, this is from Chris Janis. This is Chris Janis in Riga in Latvia. Do we go out in Latvia? Oh, no, okay. All right. Dear Craig, when will your show come out in Latvia? It would be a hit. You are pretty popular over here, honestly. Yeah, that's because the show is not out in Latvia. Anyway, you people don't speak Scamerican. This is from Dave in Syracuse, New York. Dave says, Dear Craig, my buddy says his girlfriend likes him wearing toenail polish. I think there's more to it. What do you think? I think you should mind your own business, you nosy bastard, but... I will say this about wearing toenail polish. I often wear a toenail polish. No kidding. When I spoke at the White House in 2008, I was wearing a sort of black, shiny, ebony toenail polish with a high gloss. And the reason I did that is because when I was with all of them, I remembered that I wasn't one of them. Every now and again, when I think I'm a late-night talk show host, I wear ladies' underwear, right here.
Are you as turned on as I am?
Most nights, I am, yeah.
Booyah!
Is that Scamerican for something?
Bulls.
Ah. Ah. This is from Nathan in Seymour in Indiana. Who says, Dear Craig, I was recently going through the Urban Dictionary and this random term appeared. Ferg porn. Did you see this? Ferg porn. A collection of Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson episodes stored on your TiVo or images of Craig in a folder on your computer.
Oh,
What do you think of this? I hope you don't have any of me wearing my black toenail polish. This is from Chris in Adelaide in Australia, who says, G'day, Craig. Now that you're airing here in Australia, when do you plan on coming down for a visit? We won't bite. Presently, when CBS get me a ticket down there to Australia, I'll go, so I won't be coming. This is from Lexi in San Diego in California. He says, hi, Craig, what do guys talk about when they go out for lunch together? Oh, you know, the usual stuff, our relationships, how we feel about things, where we see ourselves in a few years. We talk about
the food.
We talk about what we can see. We don't talk in abstract ideas.
Is that good? Yeah. It's awesome. Yeah.
Did you see that thing?
No. Well, then there's no point in talking about it.
Did you see that other thing?
Yeah. It was awesome. Yeah.
Do you like boobies?
No, dude, I'm gay.
Actually, I am. Call me Famke Janssen. That was like a play there. That was like if you went to see a play and you thought, oh, this play's crap, it would have been just like that. This is from Nicole in Lafayette, Louisiana, who says, hi, Craig, my boyfriend and I are moving in together next month. You two should try that with your secretariat, source. My boyfriend and I are moving in together next month. I'm excited, but he has a big dog that I can't stand. How do I tell him that I don't want to live with his dog? Do you mean penis? Well, you know, you got to say, hey, it's me or the dog. And then make some lunch plans with your girlfriends. Where you can talk about what a bastard he is. This is from Heather in Denver, Colorado. I know a girl called Heather in Denver, Colorado. When is from her? Dear Craig, no, it's not. Well, that's a relief. Dear Craig, I'm glad you finally got a haircut. I have known some girls that will cry if they get a bad haircut. Has this ever happened to you? Heather, I'm not a girl. I'm just originally from Europe, that's all. I'm not a girl. All right, sometimes I wear black toenail polish. That doesn't make me a girl. Anyway, we're done now. That's it. What time is it now, Jeff?
Break me off a piece of ads.
No, I'm surprised you said that. I thought you were going to say something different than you said the last time, but apparently not.
Bills.
Yeah, I thought you might say that, too. No surprises anymore, Jeff. Things are getting a little kind of repetitive, if you don't
well,
mind.
Well, I'm Team Jacob.
Oh, wow. Team Edward, I'm not Team Jacob.
Ooh, Edward. He bites. Booyah. In your pants. Balls.
All right, you better tell them what we're going to do next then.
Break me off a piece of ass.
Right back. All right. With Jeffrey Peterson, I'm your guest host this evening, Craig Kilborn.
Booyah!
My first guest tonight is on the big hit show Californication, which is Sundays on Showtime. Take a look at this.
Hi. Just picking up old Blackie here. Me? Oh, I'm okay.
Okay.
As good as can be expected under the circumstances, and you?
I was gonna check out the Schwartz's place.
How about Becca?
I could.
Cool.
I could catch
glad to hear that. Give her a kiss for me. Right. Hey, you wouldn't happen to have any jumper cables, would you?
Uh-huh.
No, I get it. Just keep on walking. I know. I ruined your life and all, and I couldn't be more sorry about it. But I got to get cross town to my attorney's office where lateness is frowned upon.
Okay, bye.
I think we've all been there.
Please welcome David Duchovny, everybody. David Duchovny. Delighted when you were here, David, because you were my first. You were my first guest, and look at you.
I was your first.
You've really come on, and you've got your
gentle,
own show.
Wasn't I?
You were great.
Yeah.
You never forget.
No, you never forget your first.
No, you don't. Do you remember your first?
Oh, is it time for a commercial already?
No. No, it's time for a probe.
I remember that first as well.
Well, your first probe?
Yeah. Of course I remember my first. I don't really want to discuss it. It was way back in the 20th century, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Back then, before you could get an app for it.
Yeah, they didn't. Yeah, yeah. They didn't really know how to do it.
No, we didn't. We just had to fumble our way through using hands.
Yeah. It was pretty much all done manually.
You're very hairy tonight. Are you going for what's?
Well, no. I was playing basketball on Sunday. I that's a euphemism. Playing basketball. I was playing basketball. This guy. I came down with a rebound and he elbowed me in the lip and I got a gash and a nice little purple thing here. So I can't shave without pulling half of my face off. So I figured it's better to just grow the cool goatee.
Wait. Don't applaud this elaborate lie. You just want to grow the goatee, don't you?
I don't know how to grow a goatee. I'm always staring at the mirror. Have you had facial hair?
Yeah, yeah. All of my own?
Yes.
No.
But I don't know. I don't know the styles. I've never known the styles. I don't know what they're doing now. I don't know what they were doing.
They're shaving that. You don't need to. You got the jawline. But a lot of fat guys are going for the jawline thing. Yeah,
the chin strap. I don't get that at all.
Well, you don't need it, man. Look at your jawline right there. You got the full Guy Pearce going on right there. Yeah.
Well, thank you, Craig.
Well, it's because you play basketball. That's why.
Yeah, but I've played ball my whole life, and I've never gotten hit in the face like that.
Well, who were you playing against? Were you playing against George Clooney?
I was not.
Well, there's your problem.
Yeah, yeah. I'll take that under consideration.
Right, that's right.
I go play.
Who do you play against then?
Well, I just have a weekly game in New York, where I'm living now. You know, so.
I thought you were looking a bit New York-y with your dark clothes and your kind of. Slight smell of urine.
Ooh.
No, don't you notice in New York there's a slight smell? Dave.
Thank you for saying slight.
Yeah, it's very slight. Do you have your own fragrance? A lot of the famous folks are doing that now. They get their own fragrance.
Well, I hadn't thought of it, but now I'm thinking about it.
Well, yeah.
Now that you mention urine.
Yeah.
What's urine is mine. No, it's actually...
That's rich.
Oh, yeah, I don't think you've been here since he's been
here. I saw him. I don't like him.
Yeah. No, I don't care for him either, I gotta say. He's Team Jacob, apparently.
I'm with you.
He bites.
My daughter is Team Edward, so I am, by extension, Team Edward.
You actually know about that?
Right.
Because I
have an 11-year-old daughter, so...
Right, so is that old enough to read those things? I didn't know. I thought they were...
She reads them and she goes to the movies.
Really? Have you seen the movies?
Yeah, I have.
Do you enjoy New York? I always think of you as a Californian, really.
I'm from New York. I was born and raised there.
And yet I still think of you as a Californian. What is that?
It's probably the facial hair.
That and I met you here, so I thought, he must be from here.
Yeah.
Like you probably think about me.
Yes, I Well, I love the Scottish in you. I love it because of my mother.
Your mother
talked about that.
Yeah, your mother was Scottish, as was mine.
And she loves you. She loves you, but you're on late for her. And she doesn't know how to program
anything. What, the DVR thing?
Yeah, no, nothing. She doesn't
have
DVR.
You get some money. You get some money.
She has
you
a black and white television.
She has a black and white. Oh,
no,
she's Scottish.
But it's like
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
Black and white. Black and white. It's just fine. You don't need color. That'll just lead to sin.
Right. Yeah.
True story. Yeah. What's happening in the Californication this year, then? What's going on?
Well, a lot of... Well, you saw I get nailed in the head with the phone there by my...
What happened to your lip?
No. And that was a plastic phone, you know, and because I didn't really want to get hit with a phone.
They're all plastic, man. You don't get metal phones,
no,
isn't
it? No, but like a soft plastic phone. Oh. Phone. And... you don't mind if I... I don't know why.
Here's some kangaroo testicles. You can do that to me.
They feel oddly familiar.
Yeah. Yeah. That's right.
Is that really what these are?
Well, apparently, no. I'm just saying, I got an email from a guy in Australia who said they're too small to be kangaroo testicles. They're probably wallaby testicles.
Mm. Well, I'm not an expert, but I'm guessing there's a very angry wallaby out there.
Oh, somewhere. Yeah, yeah. A very angry wallaby with a high voice. Or maybe a kangaroo on steroids. Do you still take the steroids, David?
Oh, of course.
All right, yeah. Good. That's the main thing. So what happens in the Californication?
Hank is... The motor for the whole show was that I had unwittingly had sex with an underage girl in the pilot, 16-year-old.
She was a 16-year-old pilot?
Yeah.
That would make you think she was older than 16. I can see how that could...
That's why I was misled.
Right, so you go to jail for that.
I figured if you're flying a plane, yes.
Yeah.
But it's been the secret throughout the whole series, and now it's out, and now we do deal with legal issues this year. But it's still a comedy. We're not turning into a Law and Order type show.
This show is turning into a Law and Order type show.
What would it be called? That's a tough one. I didn't mean to put you on the spot.
Yeah,
there.
No,
balls. Yeah.
You know what? He does come in handy.
He does come in every now and again. Yeah. You know,
when you're stuck.
Yeah, yeah. Every night then. Yeah. Yeah. We're out of time, David.
Oh, all right. That's fantastic.
So there you go.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. All right. Don't you close with the?
Yeah, usually an awkward pause or a harmonica. I was wondering what you would prefer: mouth organ or silence.
I'm going to try to do both. If you could humor me and just say, would you play this harmonica?
Would you play this harmonica? Oh, that's good, isn't it? Yes! Oh, yeah. Yeah. Go on. Let's go. Get the organ in your mouth, give it a good blow. Then feel better.
Could have unwrapped it.
For your old Scottish mother, are you ready? I'm sorry, Mrs. Duchovny. David Duchovny, everyone. Guest is the star of the Super Nanny show, which is on Friday nights on ABC. It's really good, actually. Take a look at this.
Landon.
It's my home.
Landon, you're not the dad or the mother.
Mum was letting the kids run riot. I mean, she had no control whatsoever.
I'm not going to fight you for the page. Ainsley, this is Landon's room. Why don't we ask if he can come in his room first? You don't need to wrestle her down, Landon. Okay, Mommy will take care of it. Landon, stop being the dad.
Here, I'll close my door.
Mum's telling Landon not to be the dad and that she can take care of it, but quite clearly she's shown the kids that she doesn't take care of things.
I don't know why she's whispering, they knew she was there.
Please welcome the adorable Joe Frost, everybody. Joe Frost. Joe Frost.
Hello, dear.
Hello.
You look lovely. What a lovely
Thank
dress.
You.
We don't
Thank
normally
you
see
much.
You out of your uniform.
I know. I've got the suit on normally. This is me getting my groove on.
Oh, I like
not
it. It's nice. Are you going somewhere interesting later?
I will be tonight, yeah.
Really?
Why not?
That's
look, hair
nice.
Made up and everything. Why
no.
not?
Yeah, no, you don't want to waste that on here. Listen, I'm impressed with your ability to wrestle those unruly midgets that you deal with. So,
You know, I've spent 20 years in childcare. I started off as a nanny
right.
in London, and, you know, being given the opportunity to really help a lot of American families is so important because, you know, we're seeing families break down, we're seeing families struggle, not having the confidence, and with my expertise, I want to be able to give and bring,
now,
you know?
Now, how did you come about that expertise? Are you from a big family yourself?
No, or? Not at all, but all I was right. a nanny for many years. Very
right.
intuitively, I'm able to really look at a situation and read it very quickly and see where the whole family need to put themselves back on track. And as you can see, I don't mince my words.
Yeah, no,
you know,
do you ever find yourself doing that with adults, though? Where, you know, when they behave like you're not the dad and everything.
No, but what I do find myself doing is I repeat a lot and it drives my friends absolutely frigging crazy.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
I have to repeat myself all the time.
Oh, yeah, no, that'd be awful.
Yeah.
No, now, is this going to be... This is going to be your last season, is that right?
Yeah, it is my last season.
Oh, wait, why?
Yeah. Because Super Nanny's given me this wonderful platform to right. be able to carry on helping families in a major way. And it's about to get exciting, Craig. It really is,
oh,
you know?
Is it? Wait,
yeah,
when?
It is. It's about to get really exciting
what,
this year.
No, what do you mean?
You know?
On the show, you mean?
No, it's about to get exciting this year with regards to what I'm going to be doing
what
now
are you
that
going to be
I've finished
then?
Doing Super Nanny. Just really moving on a much bigger platform in being able to really hone
Are you going
in.
Into space or something?
Yeah. I'm touching worldwide.
Yeah, no, that's
you know, great. Super duper nannies out there.
And do you don't have any kids of your own?
No, not yet. Are you joking? Where am I going to deliver? Like Chicago Airport or in between, like Arizona and it'd be impossible right now.
Oh.
Yeah. So I mean, I'm having spent.
You can have children in America. We've done it many times before.
Yeah, it's true. It's yeah. true. But
would you like to?
Yeah, but I've got to stop dating first, Craig.
Well, you slow down a bit, girl. Then stop
yeah.
your, you know, a little bit of balance, career,
yeah.
and you know.
Well, that's exactly what you know for me is important in being able to do. I mean, you're no good talking to all these families about the importance of finding that balance and not doing it myself. So
right. Do you have a gentleman friend then?
No, not yet. But I've been out on a few dates.
Oh, nice.
Yeah,
well,
so you, that was
what,
nice.
Not anything you like? I haven't seen anything you like.
No, not really. No, although I
well,
did
what are you
go
looking
out.
For? What you, well, that's
I did go out on a date. I went skydiving once, and it was the most, like, adventurous, exciting date, but the most unflattering because, like, you have to put this boiler suit on,
Ooh.
And like you put this helmet on,
Ooh, yeah.
and like you're going to this like skydiving. Like air machine and it sucks you in and then pulls you up and your face is all like this, you know. So you kind of you look all made
Are
up.
You
I'm just gonna say
as I am.
So you go
well,
out
did, you, did
all
you
good.
Did you see him again after this experience? Because a lot of women, if you get all those sensations going at once, they'd be like, he's the one.
He did see me again, so it couldn't be that bad.
Right, yeah. So what are you looking for in a gentleman then?
A guy, I really like a guy who's very funny and who has got confidence in themselves, they're comfortable, but hair on the back, forget about it. Have you got hair on your back?
No, I don't have hair in my back.
You're lying. Let me see.
No, I don't have hair in my back. No, I don't. Worldwide. I'm like a dolphin under here. Are you meeting a lot of hirsute gentlemen? Here's a trick. Go into if you're going to meet a guy, go and meet him. Have a banana with you. Bring it out. If he seems abnormally interested, probably got a hairy back. Move on.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Is that a thing you don't like hairy backs then?
No.
Well, okay.
No, not at all.
Well, now you know. That felt
Neither does your wife, though.
But my wife does not have a hairy
no.
back. No. No, no, she's she was like that when I met her though. Now that we're married, she'll probably, you know, have, get a hairy back. I don't think
she'll end up with a hairy back. Although I hear now, you know, you got the baby on the way.
Yeah, yeah, another one. Yeah, I've got I've got a 9-year-old and I've got another one coming. But and well, the one who's not born yet is very well behaved. And the 9-year-old's very 9-year-old's a great kid. He's,
so are you like mustering yourself up, getting ready for like the squirt of mustard poop and, you know, the sick on your back, the cottage cheese going on and
are you as turned on as I am?
I'm not even going there.
I tell you, the robot's on form tonight, if none of the rest of us are. No, I don't mind it, actually. I noticed, actually, with literally, and I think probably a lot of parents think this, I don't know if you notice this when you're dealing with very young children, but when the kids are pooing, it never bothered me. The smell of my own kids' poo, I'm like, ah, doesn't
matter. I know, but it's everybody else's, though, isn't it?
Well, I don't clean anybody else's poo. I have an absolute rule. I don't care how famous you are. Clean your own diaper.
Yeah, yeah. I tell you. Like, literally, as nannies, you know, we'd have, like, I'd do coffee mornings. Everyone would come around.
You don't want to give kids coffee. That's your mistake, right?
No. But we'd have coffee mornings and, like, the nannies would be around. All the kids would be playing. And we'd be like, poop alert. Oh, that's your one. That's certainly not mine. You know your own kids poop, right?
Oh, yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's kind of like a fine wine after a while, isn't it? Like, oh, yes. I remember I gave him the applesauce. Yeah.
Exactly.
No, I don't mind it at all. I never minded it at all. It's yeah, other people. So I don't know how good I'd be with other people's kids. Yeah. Do you think you'll be a very strict mother when you have your own?
I think I'll be firm but fair. You know, a lot of people think that, you know, I'm going to have kids that are extremely well behaved, and they think that because
good luck with that.
And they think because I deal with a lot of families who have naughty children and they misbehave, that actually my kids won't have temper tantrums. But with my personality, and you know, my mother's Mediterranean, she's Spanish, so you know, I know my kids are going to give me a run for my money.
Yeah, yeah, no, they will, yeah, yeah.
But I can't get that yet.
Well, you know,
I've got
to get
to the stage.
Mr. Skydiver sounds like he might be a keeper.
Yes. Who knows?
Well, yeah. We're out of time here, you know.
Are we?
Yeah.
Oh, so what are we going to do now?
Awkward pause or mouth organ, usually.
Really?
Yeah. What do you think? Oh, we're doing awkward pause. Are we doing awkward pause or... Oh, we are doing... Oh, right. Now let's do mouth organ. Now, have you played a mouth organ before?
No. Oh, great.
Nah, you'll be all right. It's, neither has anyone else. I just occasionally, you know, I would quite like it if a guest came out who could actually play the thing, because I can't, you know, and I think people are frankly getting tired of it. I know you are, I'm sorry.
Right, so how do I get my mouth around this?
Well, just...
That's rich.
I think you know the answer to that. Just do it, you know what I mean.
Right, okay.
Yeah, there you go.
All right.
Oh, you look firm but fair. There you go.
Okay. Right, hold on.
Yeah.
Is that too highly strung?
There actually are no strings in a mouth organ, you know.
Okay. So just blow.
Or suck. Yeah. And I don't have a hairy back. How about that? That's it, we're done. It's like the end of the Waltons. Remember the end of the Waltons? There you go. Remember that?
Yeah!
Good night, John Burke.
I said that.
Good night.
Good night, Mary Ellen.
Good night. Good night, Regis.
Yeah, good night.
Good night.
I used to love that.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's the commercial breaks now, you know.
Oh, I like this. Can we carry on?
Yeah, all right. Joe Frost, everyone, Joe Frost.
If you're going to be in the L.A. area and would like to attend a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, please call 323-570-0059.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Craig?
And then the cat farted a bird out of his arm. Well, I think we all learned a little something tonight, didn't we, everybody? I know I did. If you'd like your own Team Secretariat T-shirt, write to CBS care of Andy Rooney, CBS. And Andy will write you a very rude letter back. Good night, everybody. Say good night, kids.